is important that you keep your room nice and tidy. We will have people all week saying, this has been stolen. Someone's taken this from my room. And 99% of the time, that's a load of old rubbish. What's actually happened is it's hidden under a pair of dirty skinnies in the corner of the room. All right? And that's because you've kept your room untidy. There will be a room inspection while you are on activity every day. So this morning, when you're all out playing and doing things, a member of staff is going to check every single room. And then when you come back today, if we think you've left too bad a mess in the room, instead of doing activities, likely that you're going to... likelihood is you are going to be asked to clean up your room instead of doing activities. Right? We will score people's rooms through the week. We'll just make comments. How have people done? That's that room. That was a really good room. And we'll keep a note of that, and I will find a prize somewhere for the best room at the end of the week.
Activities today, make sure you know where you're going. If you don't know where an activity is, ask. Go to the information chalet, and if no one's there, there's a thing on the window telling you where the activities are. You must arrive on time. If you're late for an activity and you miss the safety advice, you cannot do that activity. There will be a register taken at each activity expecting you to arrive. Think about the clothes. If you're doing fencing, you'll need your arms and legs covered. All right. Think about abseiling. Girls don't turn up in dresses going down the abseiling tower. It's most unseemly and quite uncomfortable, I guess. I haven't done it myself, but Mr. Smith has told me that it is. If you are very good at bedtime tonight and the rest of the week, then when we get to Friday and we have our little show put on by the staff and our award ceremony, we'll see if we can find some money to buy you something as a reward for being very good, if you're very good every night this week. We'll try and find some chocolate and crisps and things. If you're not very good, we won't go to the trouble of trying to find the money. So make sure everybody is very good as you were last night.
Oh, my camera! Okay.
Single file, lads, please.
That's up.
Good work, Cam, now.
Thank you.
They dig the China plate out to the hillside, bring it here on rails, and then tip it into there down into the boat.
Up to you, okay, if you've got time. Right. Anybody been here before? Apart from the staff? No, okay.
Yeah.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay, how long was it last year?
No, it was about 2 3 years.
Now, if we go back to about 1775, there was nothing here in the way of a village at all. No port, no harbour. There were two or three little cottages on near the beach with fishermen and their families. Yeah? But then, in the 1770s, they discovered all around a number of uses. Girls, when you perhaps put some lipstick on or some face powder, about 90% of it's China clay. And in those days, of course, the only means of transport was either on your own 2 feet or with horses. So they had to build somewhere for all the workers to live. So they built the village as well. And between 1775 and 1774, and it's important in history, the poor North Memory. We've got to have some means of filling it up when we want to, apart from the sea. And if we look at the stream, that's always popping up the ponds, and when we want water in the dock, we can just open the sluice gates here and fill up the dock. Are very, very valuable. They're extremely difficult to sail. People work on them. The story includes a ship and the sea and some kind of, you know, interesting tale about the sea. The film companies come here with all their cameras, all their lights, all their actors, all their backup, maybe
ship. You can come here to Charleston for 6 months
or so. For these past 2 years, I feel we're finished.
Oh, Father, are things really that bad? Surely
no,
you didn't get...
No, it's no good, it's no good. I'm writing to tell Crowder that I can't pay his bill. He'll have to take Charlestown in lieu of his fees. And to think this is all my fault. Whoever would have thought that Charles Rashleigh and his daughter would be brought to near bankruptcy by two servants?
So should in theory move easily. Ours, ball and socket joints, they move quite easily, don't they? But the only trouble with this one, once it got down to about 100, your cable lowering you under the sea broke, there was no backup. So you'd float away and die. Cool. They're not very good, eh? And another good thing about these, they used to have to wear nappies. Well, think about it. If you're under the sea for any length of time,
you've never seen a dug out canoe before. This is our dug out canoe. The reason we got it here is that one of our survey ships is off the coast of Africa.
To take back up to the pit, keep the steam engine working. One day, one horse and cart. To load one ship took 150 cartfuls of China clay. So you can imagine, up and down this hill, how many horses and carts a day went up and down. It was a dirt road and it wasn't covered in tarmac. And there were grooves in the road where the side of the harbour. They pushed the carts by hand. You can see one of the chutes sticking up in the air to our left. There were lots of those that would be lowered down into the hole.
The old cob helmet apparatus isn't used much these days, I'm afraid. They say it's old-fashioned. It'll serve me well.
On the gun decks inside the ship, the wood splinters from the sides of the ship where the cannonballs hit sprayed around amongst the crew, the gun crew.
The silverware, come on, that's just some of the silverware.
Is it the mustard? I mean, I'm happy. Mustard spoon, something like that. We human beings cause 80% shipwrecks. I'll tell you about something, shall I? That one over there, where the red spot is, nobody was steering the ship, they were all having coffee or tea. The port pieces, the found 137 longbows. Any of you doing archery this afternoon? Yeah. Yes, to say sorry, you two, you three, one behind the other, please. Last time of the
Any feet come over that line now, we take 5 points away.
Ready?
You argue about it, we take another 5 points. Oh. You keep arguing, we keep taking points away, alright? So if I take some points away, the best thing for you to do is we'll get it this time.
You still can put them on to get more points.
Same again, 3 fingers pull right back, aim up a little bit.
Go.
2 points. That's it. Down the arrow. Hey, that's good. A point. So right in front of the target, remember?
How many points
are
there? I nearly got
blue. That's a point. Come on, we're going to get 3 fingers. Pull right back to 2. Keep that elbow nice and wide. That's it. That's it. That's it. Oh, further. Right back to your chin. That's it. Look down the arrow, see if it looks pointed at the target. Remember that elbow, so you don't catch it. Bend that elbow. That's
well
a point.
Done.
Well done. Name up on it.
How many goats did you have to
run? Oh, my fault. Sorry. 2 points. You know it's my fault.
I only used 2 points.
Exactly the same. Right back to the chin.
You don't get anything if it goes under.
Aim it, so it looks good, you release it. Oh, unlucky. We got ourselves, didn't it? Up a little bit. That's it. Hey, another point. Never.
And then a 10.
Oh, 6 points. Like that. Look down there.
6 points, well done.
Yeah. Go on then. Ooh. That's yellow.
Feet flat on the side of the tower, that's it. All you've got to do is thread that through and you'll go down.
Yep.
Yeah. Feel yourself going?
No. Thread that through.
You've got to let that go, that's it. That's it, let feed it through and you'll slide down.
Upwards. That's it. Brilliant, Johnny, well done. And walk down the tower. Well done. You smiling?
You guys want to put your hand on the road? Over there.
My God!
Well,
make sure you see the white
rope. Let go of the white rope now.
Okay. I'm losing it! Where are you losing?
Right there.
I'll be looking down.
Becca, Rebecca or Becca. That's it, when you foot that side of the rope.
Yeah.
One hand on here.
One hand on there, yeah.
One hand on the other rope. And just sit down into your harness. So it takes you. That's it, you can hold onto the bar if you want.
Yeah, but if I fall.
You're not falling anywhere because I've got you. Now you're going to straighten out your knees. That's it, straighten them out, straight out like that. You feel the harness has got you now, so you're not going anywhere. So you've got to straighten your legs.
They're bent at the moment.
Yeah, I know. You've just got to go down the tower. You're not going to go down if you hold on to the bar.
I don't. Can't,
I'm going to move you out like that. I've got you. Don't worry, I've got you. That's it. One hand on that one. You've got to let go of the bar or else you won't go down the tower. That's it, well done. That's the hard bit then.
Straighten your legs out. Come on. Oh, God, it's moving.
I'll stop there. Right. You're going to walk your feet in the tower. Walk
as you feed the white rope up,
so
walk down the tower.
Your, bum.
All right, keep your feet
How
back.
Do I feed it?
Push it upwards. Like you're milking the cow.
I don't like this.
That's it.
I'm stuck.
Look.
I'm stuck.
Look down again, Becca. Look at Danny Gale.
Help. No, I'm stuck.
I don't know.
Seriously. Walk down.
Becca, are you going to look up and smile for the camera?
Oh, no.
Hello.
Bye.
That's it. Keep going then.
I did that.
That's it, well done. Right, now on that foot, that side of the rope. That's it.
What do I have to do?
Put one hand on this one, that right there, and one hand on this rope here.
Yeah.
The other hand, preferably. That's it. So right, all you're going to do is you're going to sit back into your harness, like you're sitting on the toilet.
Yeah.
That's it, sit down.
Well, I stay here.
Yeah, you stay here, because I've got you. That's it, I've got you. Just got a little slack take up on the rope, and you're fine. That's it, just sit down.
Yeah.
That's it, feel it, it's got you?
Yeah.
Right then.
I don't...
One hand on there, one hand on here. One hand on this rope.
Yeah.
That's it. Straighten your legs out. That's it, well done. No, you just got to take little steps down the tower.
I can't.
Beat the white rope up slightly. Oh, God. Right.
Well, she's coming off.
Keep your feet. Your shoes will come off if you dangle your feet, right? Bring your feet up. A bit more. Shoulder width apart. That's it, brilliant. Right,
oh my
feed
God.
The white rope up, like that. And you go down.
Ooh.
And walk down the tower.
See you, Kayleen!
Oh, it's scary.
Yeah. It's scary.
I meant I put my foot down once and it went too far away. And then my foot and then my shoe and he came off, so he went down.
The cassie, there's one bit loose on that.
No, don't.
That's it. Take 1 foot over. Yeah. Do you want to hold on to my arm? That's it, that's half it done now. Right, I want to put your that foot, that side of the rope.
I can't.
That's it, you've done that bit now. Right then, I want you to put that hand on this rope here.
I can't.
You can.
It's too high.
I bet you can if you really tried.
It's too high.
Just don't look down, that's a secret. Don't look down.
Go, shorty!
Well done,
Captain. Legs.
Oh, I can't.
Did you come?
Well, will I just stay there?
Yeah. Just straighten your knees out so your legs are straight and your feet are flat against the wall. Bring your feet back up. That's it. Straighten your knees so your legs are straight. Brilliant. Feet, shoulder width apart. Ideal. Just push your white rope up and away you go.
Bring your feet back up.
Sorry, give the power a kiss.
Good part. Kylie? Right there. That's it. Put that foot the other side of the rope. That's it, well done. Right then, one hand on here. One hand on there. That's it, you got it. And just sit down into your harness, like everyone else has done. Yeah, well done. Straighten your legs, feet flat on the side. And set that white rope feed through your fingers. That's it. Got to get your feet a little bit wider. So you're more balanced. That's it. Well done. Yeah, you're a natural.
Can you give us a wave?
You take both your hands off and wave. Yeah, I bet you can.
What do you do?
How do you
like that shot? Feed the white rope up like that. Push it up, push it upwards. I want you to hold this in this hand, and that rope in that hand, right? All I want you to do is straighten your knees out.
Oh, I can't do this.
Yes, you can.
I can't.
Full confidence in you.
Yeah? Right. You do straighten your legs out. Hold on to that there, hold on to there. Put your elbow to the other side. You need to let go of the bars, go down. That's it, well done. Doing the hard bit now. That's it, well done.
What do I do, release this?
No, you just let that. That's it, well done. Love you, Jill. That's it, well done.
How do you let go? But let go of that rope. Right, put your feet flat against the wall, knees straight. Bring your legs up, walk back up the tower. That's it. Legs shoulder width apart. That's it. Feed the white rope up, like that.
That's how you do it.
Next to
better.
Thank you.